Hello, Year 9. It's Mr. Shabir here. Obviously, there's a reason why we're doing online learning. Hope you all are safe and healthy. I'll be releasing some videos that will hopefully help you with the lessons that I'll be posting up on Google Classrooms. Thank you for all those who have been submitting work so far, including the work last week. All right, so today's lesson, which I already posted up, but I'm going to make this video just for those who may be struggling slightly, just so you understand the task a bit clearer, even more clearer. All right, so all of you should have your booklets. You've taken your books home, art books. And so I'm gonna explain what you need to do today's lesson. So we had started our ideas in the style of Kandinsky. So I got you to create boxes like this, like you can see on the board. I will split your page up in half, and you're going to create one idea. You listen to select the type of music. Remember, it needs to be a suitable, appropriate song. And you're going to do create a piece of art in the style of Kandinsky, okay? If you are struggling, just look through your booklets, because you have done keys, for example, shape keys, color keys, okay? So use that type of information that you've got in your booklets to help you to create these ideas. So, first of all, the task is to complete both ideas. I know some of you already started or almost completed them. Remember, just down here, remember to write the name of the song that's inspired you to create these two ideas. And then, which a lot of you will be moving on to, is the final idea in this box. So once you've completed your idea, and ideas one and two, use your techniques and ideas that you created here, that you've learned to create a final design, and this can be a completely different song that you like. So just to recap, you need to create idea one, listen to a song, and create an idea one. It needs to be in the style of Kandinsky. Listen to another song, create idea two, and then listen to a third song, and create your final design, and you can take inspiration from your first two ideas. So now I'm going to show you some examples of what your work should be looking like, okay? Okay, so here are some examples of what the work should be looking like. It might be a bit unclear from the camera, but this slide, this presentation will be on Google Classrooms for you to have a look in your own time. This is the slide that's probably better for you to have a look at. This is what we're after. This type of style for your final design. I don't want to see no just squiggles or there's no thought process going behind it. Here you can see there's different shapes, different colors. Here you've got lines, you've got waves here. Here you've got different shapes and patterns. You've got the name of the music that this person was listening to. And that's what you need to be doing for idea one, two, and your final design. As always, if there's anything that you're struggling with or confused about, just drop me a message on Google Classrooms and I will get back to you as soon as possible. I have created a fourth slide. And once you have designed your final design and your design one and two, I want you to take a picture using your phones and then I want you to paste it into this fourth slide. Okay? I don't mind how you do it in terms of if you copy and paste, download, whatever, and send it as attachment, whatever you do, but I want to see a picture of what you did. Okay, so your design idea one, design idea two, and your final design. Okay, thank you very much.